Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll start a ticketing series in Discord PY. So to demonstrate, let's click this button, and it's created a ticket. Okay, now let's go to the developer portal. Okay, for this series, your bot will need the bot and application commands scopes, and it'll need send messages, embed links, attach files, read message history, mention everyone, manage roles, manage channels, and read messages slash view channels permissions. Now let's go to our code. Okay, we're going to be building off of our Discord PY slash commands framework from our Discord PY slash commands video. If you want more info about this code, feel free to watch the video in the linked card up here. Okay, first let's work on our view. Okay, so this is our view. It's sort of like a container for our buttons. So we have timeout here equal to none because we don't want the view to expire. We want it to be persistent. So even after our bot gets restarted, the button will still work once we add it in our onReady. Okay, now let's go look at the documentation for buttons. Okay, so this is discord.ui.button. So we're going to be using the label. We'll call it create a ticket. And then you can choose a color, your style. So you have like purple, red, green, and gray. And then you can have an emoji if you want to. We won't be using that. And we'll need a custom ID. For persistent views, like the one that we will have, every item inside of your persistent view will need to have a custom ID. Okay, now let's go back to our code. So let's create our button now. Okay, so this is our button. We're going to call it create a ticket. Style is going to be blurple, and our custom ID is going to be ticket button. Okay, now let's work on our callback. Okay, so in our callback, we have self, which is the view, interaction, which is the interaction, and the button. Now we want to check if a ticket already exists for the user in the server. If it does, then we'll respond saying that you already have a ticket open. If they do not have a ticket already open, then we will create a ticket for them. Okay, so we're going to be using utils.get to search the text channels and see if a text channel is called ticket-for-user's name and then dash their discriminator. Okay, so if the bot cannot find a ticket already open, then it'll return none for ticket. So we check if ticket is none. If it is not none, then that means they already have a ticket open, and then we can respond saying you already have a ticket open. So what this will do is that it'll check if ticket is not none. If it's not none, that means it'll return the channel. So we'll respond saying you already have a ticket open, and then we'll mention the channel, and the message will be ephemeral. Okay, if a ticket is not found, so if it's none, then we will create a ticket for them. Okay, since our ticket is a private channel, we'll need to specify our permission overrides. Like, we'll have to make sure that at everyone, the default role cannot view the channel, that the user can view the channel, send messages, etc., and that the bot can also view the channel, send messages, and read message history. Okay, so these are our permission overrides. So for everyone, so at everyone, the default role, we need to make sure that they cannot view the channel. And for the user, the person who clicked the button, we set their permissions to view channel to true, send messages to true, attach files and embed links to true. And then for the bot, which is me, the permissions would be view channel, send messages, and read message history. Okay, now let's create our channel. Okay, so this will create a text channel. We're going to call a ticket for the user's name and their discriminator. And we're going to set our overrides to these overrides here. And then for reason, which will appear in the audit log, it'll say that we created a ticket for the user. Okay, in the newly generated ticket, we can send a message saying that the user created a ticket. And then we can respond to the user to the initial interaction saying that we've opened a ticket for them. Okay, so we're basically done with the view. So now let's work on launching the view. So in our slash command, we can just create an embed and then attach the view to it. Okay, so what this will do is that it'll create an embed, and then the title will be if you need support, click the button below and create a ticket. And its color is going to be blue. And then we're going to send the embed and the view to the interaction.channel. So where the channel that the slash command was executed in, and then we're going to respond to the user saying ticketing system launched with an ephemeral message. Okay, now we need to add our view ticket launcher in our onReady. This way, the view will become persistent, so whenever a bot restarts, the button will still be able to accept input. Okay, we're pretty much done with our code. Now let's run the code and test it out. Okay, now let's go to Discord. Let's run ticket. And it's launched the embed. Let's click the button. And it's created a channel. And it says when create a ticket and mention me. And if we try to create a ticket again, it says you already have a ticket open at here. Okay, so in the next episodes, we're going to be working on some more advanced things. This is just the basic setup. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. The link is on screen. Thank you for watching.